Today, I want to speak about one of my favorite groove metal bands. Some people will say also they are very close to the metalcore genre. In any case, I'm speaking about Lamb of God from Virginia of United States of America. And I have to say that I'm not a follower of metalcore or of groove metal. I like some things inside these genres, but for me this is not something that I listen all the day. In any case, Lamb of God, they are one of the best all groove metal or new wave of American heavy metal. Say that in I don't care about the names. One of the best a modern American groove metal bands. So, they started in 1994 by another name. Their first name was Burn the Priest, and by this name they made their first debut album, Burn the Priest, in 1999. Afterwards, in 2000, at the beginning of the millennium, they changed the name Lamb of God. And also in 2018 they made another another album by the name Burn the Priest, but they played covers by the name Legion XX or 20, something like that. Here I will not speak about Burn the Priest, about this first album, or about the album of the covers of 2018. I'm speaking about only the 8 studio albums by the name Lamb of God. From the beginning, the band, in the beginning, they were Randy Blythe, the singer and the frontman of them. The brothers, William Adler in the guitars and Chris Adler in the drums. John Campbell, the bassist, and Mark Morton also in the guitars. They became so famous, they started to become famous with their second album As the Lamb of God, in the days of As the Palaces Burn. Afterwards, even more with their third album Aces of the Wake, and with their fourth album Sacramentum, they became so great, one of the best metal bands of our times. But afterwards they had some problems. In 2012 in Czechia, it was an accident when Randy Blythe by mistake killed one of the fans of the band. So it was a very, very, very difficult period for the band. The police, the Czech police arrested him, and he was in prison with trial and all these things until 2015. So the band made a big hiatus, and afterwards they had another hiatus from 2017 until 2018. Not only that, Chris Adler, he played with Megadeth in their Dystopia album, and in 2019 Chris Adler left the band. So today the drummer is Art Cruz from the prog thrash metal band Pronk from United States. So let's start to rank their albums from worst to best, in my personal, of course, opinion. In the 8th place for me comes their debut album. I'm not speaking about Burn the Priest. Their debut album of 2000 by the name New American Gospel. This is not bad album, but this is even the, for me, is a little bit more hardcore, if you understand what I am saying. In the 7th place, another one of them, One of their famous albums that many fans of the band, they like it very much, but unfortunately I can't connect with it very much. Speaking about their fifth album of 2009, Worth. In the sixth place, their last album, their eighth album of 2020, by the name Lamb of God. For me, it was one of the best albums of 2020. One year that we had so many good albums in this year. It's a good album, and also it's the first album without Chris Adler in the drums. But I like it. I like it. In the fifth place, their seventh album, by the name Seven, they have the Latin number of seven, and a German title, if I'm not sure, Sturm, Storm und Drang, something like that, of 2015. This is the seventh album of them. It came out after that Blythe came out from the prison. So here you can find a very strong album with some very melodic elements in their music, but I like it. I like this so much. Songs like Overlord. I like this album very, very much. Now, in the fourth place, the first album that I listened from them, their third album of 2004, Aces of the Wake. And this album is the most metalcore album of them. When I listened to this first time, I thought that, okay, it's a good album, a good band. I thought that they are even more metalcore than groove metal. But in any case, afterwards, I didn't listen to them for much time. And I will say when I came back to be a fan of Lamb of God. Now, in the third place, another album that many people, they don't like it, but I like it so much. Their sixth album of 2012, Resolution. Yes, I like this album very much. And now, in the second place, their second album of 2003, As the Palaces Burn. For me, this is one of the best groove metal albums of Lamb of God. So good. And in the last, but the first place, of course, their masterpiece, Sacramentum, of 2006, their fourth album. And so good album, I started to listen to them even more when this album came out. Walk With Me in Hell, Again We Rise, Redneck, it's a very Pantera-style song, Pathetic, Black and the Cursed Sun, Forgotten, Requiem, so great album. For me, this is one of the best albums of the millennium. So, from Israel and from Jerusalem, stay metal and stay heavy.